Are you ready to test your vocabulary in English? Of course you are, because after all, you just clicked on this video, right? Come on, Thiago, duh. So we have compiled 20 questions to test your vocabulary using the Toy Story movies, the 4 Toy Story movies. Really cool, right? But don't think this test is gonna be easy, because all the words I've selected for you today range from the levels B2 up to C2, so they are more advanced words. But you know what? Don't worry, because even if you don't get all the questions correctly, I'm sure you will still have the chance to learn a ton of new words and vocabulary that are more advanced. But before we get started, make sure you hit that subscribe button and bell down below, because every week there's a new video here on the channel to help you understand your favorite movies, TV series, and test your English from time to time, without getting lost, without missing the jokes, and without subtitles. So hit the subscribe button in order not to miss a single new lesson.
Hey, who moved my doodle pad way over here?
Ah! How you doing, Rex?
Were you scared? Tell me honestly.
I was close to being scared that time.
Oh, I'm going for fearsome here, but I just don't feel it.
Which word is closest in meaning to the adjective fearsome? Intense, frightening, aggressive. The word fearsome means the same as frightening or scary, especially in appearance. For example, my favorite part of the movie is when the monster shows his fearsome teeth.
Pardon me, I hate to break up the staff meeting, but they're here! Birthday guests at 3 o'clock!
Stay calm, everyone!
Meeting adjourned.
What does Woody mean when he says meeting adjourned? The meeting is short, the meeting is successful, the meeting is over. The word adjourn means to temporarily end a meeting or to have a pause in a meeting. It's important to remember that this is a formal word and it is commonly used in formal situations, such as trials, as well as business and government meetings. For example, the meeting was adjourned until Tuesday.
Hey guys, look! It's the real Buzz Lightyear!
You're mocking me, aren't you?
Oh no. Buzz, look, an alien!
Where?
Ah!
When you mock someone, you make fun of someone, have fun with someone, laugh with someone. When you mock someone, you laugh at that person and make fun of them, usually in an unkind way. Woody is making fun of Buzz because Buzz truly believes he's a space ranger, not a toy. For example, they were mocking him because he kept falling off his bike.
Because of you, the security of this entire universe is in jeopardy.
What? What are you talking about?
Right now, poised at the edge of the galaxy, Emperor Zurg has been secretly building a weapon with the destructive capacity to annihilate an entire planet.
When Buzz says that the universe is in jeopardy, he means the universe is vast, the universe is in danger, the universe is safe. When something is in jeopardy, it is in danger of being damaged or destroyed. In other words, it is at risk. For example, the lives of thousands of birds are in jeopardy because of the oil spill.
Who's in charge here?
The Claw!
The Claw is our master.
The Claw chooses who will go and who will stay.
This is ludicrous.
Hey, Bozo, you got a brain in there?
A synonym for ludicrous is ridiculous, serious, irrelevant. Something ludicrous is ridiculous, foolish, and unreasonable. In other words, it doesn't make any sense. For example, some movies that initially seem ludicrous turn out to be quite interesting by the end. Lots of great vocabulary today, huh? If you want to truly become a confident English speaker, you need to expand your vocabulary. This certainly happened to me. After studying for a few years, I got to a pretty comfortable level of English, around B2, let's say, upper intermediate. But it was only when I deliberately studied and learned words that are more advanced, C1 and C2 level words, that I felt even more confident as an English speaker and user. And you know what? You can practice and improve your vocabulary by using the Real Life English app. This is because the app uses cutting-edge technology that helps to memorize the words you learn much faster. You can learn tons of words, phrasal verbs, and idioms while improving your listening skills with our world-class podcast. And also, never speak alone again. With the app, you can connect to another English learner anywhere in the world to have a short conversation in real time. The app has a rating of 4.9 stars and tons of happy users. Check out this review. Nice app. Such a nice app with so many great tools. I recommend it to all my friends who intend to learn English. So if you want to go from feeling like a lost, insecure English learner to becoming a confident, natural English speaker, make sure you download the Real Life English app. It's free to download and try. By the way, once you download the app and install it, don't forget to try the Fluency Challenge. The Fluency Challenge is a series of mini lessons designed to teach you and to introduce to you all the amazing features the app has. And once you finish the Fluency Challenge and you complete it successfully, we have a special gift for you. So download the app right now and see it for yourself. The link will be here in the description of this video, also up here, or you can go to Google Play Store, Apple App Store, search for Real Life English and download the app from there. But now let's get back to our advanced vocabulary test with Toy Story. Fun fact time! Which famous actor voices Woody in the four main movies of the Toy Story franchise? Cillian Murphy, Tom Cruise, Tom Hanks.
All right, listen, 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 listen. No one's getting replaced.
That's Chick Chick Chick.
Cry out loud, it's this one.
I despise that chicken.
Fellas.
If you despise something, you misunderstand it, dislike it, accept it. To despise means to dislike or not like something or someone. For example, I despise movies that have open endings.
Well, why didn't you yell for help?
Well, I tried squeaking, but I'm still broken. No one could hear me. Besides, the dust aggravates my condition. What's the point in prolonging the inevitable?
The word aggravate has a positive connotation, negative connotation. To aggravate means to make it worse. Imagine a situation that is already bad, but then something else happens that aggravates the situation. In other words, it makes the situation worse. For example, I had a headache, so I took some medicine, but it only aggravated the pain.
You're breaking ranks, Ranger. Buzz Lightyear to Star Command. I've got an AWOL Space Ranger.
Tell me I wasn't this deluded.
No backtalk!
A deluded person believes things that are not real, believes things that are true, believes things that people say. The word deluded is an adjective used to describe people who believe in things that don't exist. For example, poor deluded girl. She thinks she's gonna get the job after a terrible interview.
You see, all along we thought the way into Zerg's fortress was through the main gate, but in fact, the secret entrance is to the left, hidden in the shadows.
To the left and in the shadows, got it.
Which word below is closely related to entrance? Enthrall, eject, enter. The word entrance is a noun. The verb form of entrance is to enter. Even though they have the same meaning, the way you use these words in a sentence is a bit different. Take a look at these examples. She entered his office and sat down. Here, I'm using enter as the verb. She got into the building through the main entrance. In this example, I'm using entrance, the noun.
He's ascending in the vertical transporter. All right, everyone. Hang on, we're gonna blast through the roof.
Buzz?
To infinity and beyond!
To blast means to explode, to destroy, to break through. To blast something means to explode or destroy something with explosives, or to break through or hit something with a similar, very strong force. For example, they blasted tunnels to build the main road. Fun fact time! Which famous entrepreneur was the co-founder of Pixar, the animation studio that produced Toy Story? Bill Gates, Steve Jobs, Jeff Bezos? To be on a rampage means to move and do things in a wild, violent way, to move and do things in a calm, relaxed way, to move and do things in a quiet way. The verb to rampage means to move, run, and do things in an uncontrolled, violent manner. Andy is playing with his baby sister, Molly, by calling her a violent, giant baby who will destroy the toys. It's really nice to see Andy including his baby sister in the fun like this. While the way this word is being used here is cute, rampage is usually used in negative contexts where there's violence involved. Here's another example with this word. Many young people went on a rampage, smashing windows and setting fire to cars.
Keep your accessories with you at all times. Spare parts, batteries, anything you need for an orderly transition.
Orderly? Don't you get it? We're done, finished, over the hill.
Hey, now come on, guys. We all knew this day was coming.
Yeah.
If something is orderly, it is messy, organized, untidy. If something happens in an orderly way, it happens in an organized way, with order. For example, the passengers were asked to leave the plane in an orderly fashion.
But through every yard sale, every spring cleaning, Andy held on to us. He must care about us or we wouldn't be here.
You wait. Andy's gonna tuck us in the attic. It'll be safe and warm.
And we'll all be together.
Exactly.
Based on the context of the clip, we can associate the phrase tuck us in with danger, memory, comfort. This is a phrasal verb, to tuck someone in. We usually say this when talking about making someone, especially a child, comfortable in bed before sleeping, by arranging the covers around them. For example, I always tuck my daughter in and she sleeps the whole night.
Woody was wrong.
Wait, hold on. This is no time to be hysterical.
It's the perfect time to be hysterical.
Should we be hysterical?
No.
Yes.
Maybe, but not right now.
A hysterical person plans, overreacts, discusses. If somebody is being hysterical, this person is unable to control their emotions because they are scared, angry, or anxious. But in informal situations, you can also use the word hysterical to refer to something extremely funny. For example, his latest movie was hysterical. I laughed so hard.
Well, now I'll tell you. When the kids get old, new ones come in. When they get old, new ones replace them. You'll never be outgrown or neglected, never abandoned or forgotten.
If you outgrow something, you grow it in your backyard, lose interest in it as you get older, start using it more often. To outgrow means to lose interest in something as you get older. For example, in Toy Story 3, Andy is now an adult who goes to college. Now he's not interested in playing with his toys anymore because he has grown up. In other words, Andy has outgrown Woody, Buzz, and their friends. Here's another example. She used to use a pacifier to fall asleep, but now she has outgrown it. Fun fact time! What's the name of Toy Story's theme song composed by Randy Newman? You have a friend in me? You need a friend like me? You've got a friend in me.
You got a friend in me.
All right.
Yeah, you got a friend in me.
Score!
You got a friend
wow,
in
cool.
me.
What do you think?
Oh, this looks great, Mom.
Okay, birthday boy.
To shove means to push someone or something with force, to move your body to make space for someone else. Both are correct. Here's an example with each one of those meanings. Many people in the crowd were shoving each other, trying to get closer to the singer on stage. Could you shove up so Tina can sit next to you?
I know that was you, Potato Head.
Everyone, listen, I thought I told you. When Mom quickly cleans the bedroom like that, expect to be put in the closet.
How much longer?
Keep it to a dull roar, Rex. Deep breaths, Jesse, deep breaths.
Keep it to a dull roar is an idiomatic expression. Based on the scene you just saw, what do you think it means?
Keep it to a dull roar, Rex.
Be relaxed, be quiet, be ready. The expression keep it to a dull roar is an informal way of telling someone to keep their noise or activity at a moderate level. It's often used in situations where you want to maintain a sense of calm or not draw too much attention to what you're doing. For example, if you're in a library and someone is talking loudly, you might say, "Hey, can you keep it to a dull roar?" Essentially, it's a request to be quieter or less disruptive.
I remember with Andy, I would go to school
uh-huh.
with him.
I'm sorry, Woody. I hate to sound like a broken record, but Bonnie's not Andy.
No, of course, I get that. But if you would just...
To sound like a broken record is also an idiomatic expression. Based on the scene you just saw, what do you think it means?
I'm sorry, Woody. I hate to sound like a broken record, but...
To say something repeatedly, to say something carefully, to say something angrily. To say that someone sounds like a broken record means that they are repeating themselves, often saying the same thing over and over again in a monotonous or annoying manner. The phrase is derived from the days of vinyl records, which, when scratched or damaged, would cause a section of the recording to repeat in a loop, creating a repetitive and irritating sound. So, when you tell someone that they sound like a broken record, you're essentially telling them that they are repeating themselves excessively and it's becoming tedious or irritating to listen to.
That part of you that tells you things, what you're really thinking?
Fascinating. So your inner voice advises you.
Another word for inner could be interest, inside, impunity. The word inner is an adjective that is used to describe something that is located on the inside or within something else. It pertains to the interior or internal aspect of a person, object, or concept. Here are a few examples of how inner can be used. Inner thoughts. These are the thoughts and feelings that a person has, but may not necessarily express to others. They are often deeply personal and reflective. Inner circle. This refers to a close-knit group of people who are trusted and have a special relationship with someone, such as a leader or a person of influence. Inner workings. This phrase is used to describe the internal mechanisms or processes of a system or organization. Inner peace. This is a state of calm and contentment that comes from within a person, often associated with being emotionally balanced and free from stress. So, inner generally conveys the idea of something being internal, hidden, or related to one's personal or emotional state.
Hey, howdy! Hey there! Sorry to bother you, but...
Why, you're not a bother at all. We were just out for my early morning stroll. And look!
To stroll means to talk, to run, to walk. To stroll means to walk in a slow, relaxed manner, especially for pleasure. It is often used to describe a leisurely walk in a park, along a beach, or through a town or village. Here are some examples of how the word stroll can be used in a sentence. The couple strolled hand in hand through the park. We strolled along the beach, enjoying the sunset. All right, are you ready for the results? Let's do it. Remember that all these words we saw today, they are more advanced. So they are between upper intermediate and advanced levels. So, on to the results. If you got between 4 to 8 questions right, your vocabulary level might be around B2, upper intermediate. If you got between 9 and 14 questions right, your vocabulary level might be around C1, advanced. Finally, if you got between 15 and 20 questions right, your vocabulary level might be around C2, proficient. In order to consider your vocabulary level advanced, you will need to get at least 15 or 16 questions correct here. But remember, this is an informal test and our main purpose here is to teach you some advanced words while having fun. This does not replace a proper proficiency exam. So, how many correct answers did you get? Leave your results here in the comment section below. I'm curious to see how well you did. But for now, guys, awesome, great job, you rock. You've made it until the end of the lesson or test. Don't forget to like this video, share this video with a friend who's also learning English and who's looking to test their vocabulary knowledge, and subscribe to the channel in case you're not a subscriber yet. And if you want to keep learning English while having a ton of fun, check out this next lesson. See you soon.
So if you can even just start listening when you're listening to a podcast or you're watching a TV series, just kind of humming along with that, kind of capturing the musicality of it, you're going to tune your ear to how those sounds are produced in English. And even that's going to help a lot, even before getting into the technicalities of the pronunciation of individual sounds. So that's something I recommend that people give a go. And I also really liked what you were saying, because it just reminded me of this clip I just saw of Ana de Armas, Oscar-nominated actress from Cuba. And she was talking about, it was on Saturday Night Live, and she's talking about basically how she got into acting.